Hi Gawkers, it's November 7th. I promised I'd make this video. It may be a little rambling, but it makes me crazy. Hi Gawkers. Last Tuesday to be exact, in this very video, I mentioned I would make another video. So, here goes. It may not be the funniest thing you've ever heard. It's probably not that exciting. But let me tell you why on election day, here in Alabama, I get so ticked off. Sorry. It almost came out. It really makes me mad. Here in Alabama, we have, because of our state constitution, we have to vote as a state on local issues. The Constitution of Alabama, which was written in 1901, is set up so that if, say, a county wants to raise a school tax, they want to tax themselves a couple of mills for their schools in their local county, they're not allowed to do it. They have to go to Montgomery and get an amendment to the Constitution on the ballot. The state as a whole then votes on it. If it passes, then that local county can go back and raise their tax, or whatever that local issue is. It's insane, especially since when you have something on the ballot that says, so you can raise a tax, everybody goes, no, 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 no taxes, no taxes, no taxes. So these things hardly ever pass. They tried for a few years, I remember, back in the 80s, early 90s. Somebody got the bright idea to write them all convoluted and backwards so that if you voted no, you were really voting for the thing. That didn't help either. So what do we do about it? A lot of people guise this as home rule. They want to give the power back to the local community. I agree with that, but it's more than just home rule. It is pure, unadulterated, the last vestige of racism in Alabama. Now, when you think of Alabama, I know you have your prejudices. We're all Klansmen down here and a bunch of rednecks. It's not like that. Yeah, there are prejudiced people here. There are prejudiced people everywhere. I don't care where you go. You can go as far north as Greenland and you're going to find prejudiced people. But here in Alabama, it ain't like that. But our Constitution was written in 1901. So, what does that mean? The Constitution was written in 1901. Put your mindset in the headspace of a white guy from Alabama in 1901, because white guys were the guys writing the Constitution. It's been 36 years since the South lost the Civil War. That's fewer years than I've been alive. Some of the guys elected to write the Constitution in 1901 were alive at the time the Civil War was going on. They, theoretically, could have actually fought in the Civil War. So here they are in 1901, writing the Constitution for the state. Very much, they are prejudiced, bigoted, white folk. I'm sorry, but that's the way it was in 1901, and not just in Alabama. But they all get together and they want to write this Constitution, but they know that there are large enclaves, counties in Alabama, which are 60, 65, 70, 78% black. And they are to this day. If you look at the demographics of the state of Alabama, go to the Census Bureau, you can check it out. There are counties in southern Alabama, especially in southern Alabama, that are a very high majority of black people. So these guys in 1901 are going, holy crap, we can't just give them local rule. They'll run away with this stuff. They'll vote in all sorts of crazy crap. So what did they do? They said, hey, the state as a whole is mostly white, because Alabama is like the rest of the United States. We're about 11 to 15% black. And the rest of it, you know, mostly white, and then a few Hispanics thrown in, and that kind of stuff. That's majority white. So they said, the state as a whole is white, so what we'll do is we'll make all these little local communities have to go to the entire state as a whole to have these local decisions ratified. And to really make it a pain, we'll make them amendments to the Constitution. So the state constitution of 1901 is about yay thick. It's a book. I swear to God, it's like six inches thick with all the amendments in it. The thing is massive because we have to amend our Constitution for every little thing. Let me read something to you. I looked this up because it drives me crazy, and I found this place called constitutionalreform.org. They are apparently a little group here in Alabama that is trying to get the Constitution completely rewritten, which I am all about. I haven't joined, but let me just read this to you. The 1901 Alabama Constitution was written by men who wanted to deny rights to some citizens. Who were they? Who were they? I think we know who they were. Those were the black folks. And keep control in their own hands. They're a bunch of rich white guys from Montgomery and Birmingham and Mobile and here in Huntsville. And they want to keep control. You know, power begets power. And that's how the Constitution controls our state today. It continues to disenfranchise local citizens, families, economic development, and public transit. Did you know that in the state of Alabama, taxes collected from automobile sales or manufacturing, highway taxes and tolls, cannot be used to fund public transportation? It can only go back to the highway system. I wonder why. Who do you think drove the cars and who do you think rode the buses back in the early 20th and mid-20th century here in Alabama? Oh, that's right. White guys were driving the cars. The black people, the poor people, were on the public transit. And God forbid we make that comfortable and convenient for them. Oh, dear God, rewrite the Constitution of Alabama. But until we do, the only thing we as Alabamians should do to motivate and hasten this process along is every time we get to go vote and you see an amendment to the Constitution, I don't care if it says give every Alabamian a brick of gold, vote no. And the stalemate and the upheaval and the pig-headedness in Montgomery will crumble if we just block every single amendment, create a stalemate in the system. And then these local communities are going to go, screw you, Montgomery. Change it. Rewrite the Constitution. Okay, I'm worked up. I'm in a lather.
All right, campers, good work today. Lights out, and we'll see you tomorrow for more exercise and proper diet.
Alright, so that's in a nutshell. Come to Alabama, vote no on everything. Please, for the love of cake, vote no. If it says, look, if it says the governor will come to your house and give you a big sack of money, vote no. Vote no and make them rewrite the Constitution of 1901. The Alabama Constitution of 1901 is nothing but the last vestige of racism in the state of Alabama. Get rid of it. Get rid of it. Kill it all and let some smarter guys sort it out. I'll rewrite the Constitution. I'll be on that committee any day. I never became a lawyer, but hell, I can play one on TV.